guys, how's everyone doing? This is your guy, Assassin Dave. Welcome back to Foreign Famous Family again. Today we're gonna show you how to carry a game in Go Lane with Clint 4v5. Yeah, that's right, it was one person completely AFK from the beginning to end. Well, actually, that person came to my lane, soaked some minion waves, and just went AFK afterwards. I mean, you could have just gone AFK since the beginning of the game, because that could have done me a huge favor. But you will see that this Bane come to my lane, starting off the game, decided I'm gonna take a tour on the goal lane because it looks pretty cool. And then just decided, yeah, this game is unplayable. And he just walked away. AFK'd afterwards. And this is something that you're gonna see always when you're playing solo queue. But you should never give up because you're playing the goal lane marksman. Because you're playing the money making technique. You understand how to farm, you understand how to carry. All you have to do is carry the plan through, in and out, and win the game. Now, before we get into the gameplay, guys, make sure to drop the like, subscribe, and turn the bell on to all notification bells so you can join the coolest, greatest, the baddest family in the world of Mobile Legends. And remember to re-download your Mobile Legends with the link in the description so you can get extra 15-25% extra diamonds every time you make a purchase in Mobile Legends. That's right, it's a lot of extra diamonds. I know. Now, coming to this gameplay. You can see right here, Bane is just walking up and down, and now he's AFKing under the tower. I have no idea what he's doing. I think he just had bad internet. But hey, whatever reason might be, if you want to go AFK early so people can restart a match, right? But if you go AFK like 2 minutes afterwards, this is not the most ideal, you know? Now everybody have to wait. And you can see earlier this game, because I don't have any support, I don't have any vision, the enemy team decided to focus me on the top lane. So even though I'm trying to farm as much as I can, there's no way I could have predicted if I just walk up one step that Gu Xian was sitting in the bush, because I haven't seen Gu Xian since the beginning. I never seen Gu Xian. I don't know where he is. I mean, it's possible around 2 minute mark that Gu Xian will gank you, because 2 minute mark is usually when a turtle spawns, and the enemy jungle, if they start with blue, they will rotate all the way to your side, or if you're on the other side of the blue, right? So it's very likely that Gu Xian was ganking me, but all I did was step up one step and I got ganked by Gu Xian. And because of that play, it made me play a lot more cautious, you know, to kind of guess where Gu Xian is the whole time. And that's something you gotta do, but sometimes you gotta take the risk to farm, to harass, to poke. You shouldn't have done that. Like at this point, what I should have done is just go home. But I see Gu Xian on the bottom lane and it's Bruno ulted, so I immediately go back. And this is what I do to farm. I take this gold crab always into this bush right here. So this way I can farm in safely. Now, you just have to learn that not to step up after you try to farm the gold crab, right? Like, you take the gold crab to the bush, kill the gold crab, and take a longer route from the interior of the rock. That's the safer way to rotate. But because I didn't do that, I think I got punished a second time on the top lane by Gu Xian. Just some of the mistakes that happens. Because right now I have no idea where Gu Xian is. So there's no way I'm gonna walk close to that bush. I'm just gonna clear my way and then go back to my jungle and farm, right? And this is something that you can do when you're on top lane. You can always farm this little camp next to the wall. Now, I don't know what happened to camp. I remember that it used to be where I can sit on the other side and the camp will start all attacking me because it's a ranged camp. But now, I think they changed it where even if I'm standing next to the wall, the minion will still kind of circle around the rock because it doesn't have enough range. Alright, we're gonna skip a little bit of farming here and come to this side. I see this Lunox sitting in this bush, and I decided to bait out her ultimate. I know she cannot kill me right away because she does have a dash, but obviously I think Lunox just misplayed a little bit. All I wanted was to kind of distract this Lunox so he doesn't join the team fight. But at this point, it's not really my job to do that because it's just way too risky, you know? Somebody else should have done it. And once again, right after I go to my lane, you should always get the gold crab whenever you can. Whenever you can in the gold lane, okay? But all you need to do is take the gold crab into this bush, so it's safer. You can stand in the bush, and even the people who are standing right next to you, they wouldn't know, unless they're paying attention to the audio. If they pay attention to the audio, they will hear blah, 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 blah. They will hear auto attack sound if they're next to you. But if they're not paying attention, they wouldn't hear you. So over here, I see the Bruno, and I instantly come here to fight him. I think there's where I got baited. Yeah, sure enough, Gu Xian was here one more time. So this is the second death. But right after I come back, guys, I'm never gonna go back to top lane again. Because top lane is way too risky as a marksman. Now, there's a huge update in the advanced server on the gameplay of Mobile Legends, where right now, the gold lane will last all the way until 5 minutes. But before the update, it's still 350, you're gonna have all the enhanced minion waves, so you're done. After that, you're done with the enhanced minion waves. You should have just go to the mid lane. But after the update, you might stay top lane, stay in the gold lane a little bit longer until 5 minutes. That means your team should come help you a little bit more. And I don't think it's a good idea to put like a marksman on the top side of the map with zero protection. But obviously when you play solo queue, it is just what it is. You just have to kind of stay top lane. Sometimes you might even give up the gold just so you can, you know, don't die that much. But after I'm done with top lane, you will see throughout the rest of the game, I'm always going to be rotating with my team. And I talk about it when I play other marksmen like Mia, Layla. It's very, very important at this point to not go by yourself. It might seem like there's farm there, but it's better if you just don't die. So the best scenario is to farm your own jungle and then farm with the team to push towers and then go to a lane that's safe, right? The safest lane is always going to be the mid lane because it's the shortest lane. So you can get out of a tower really fast. You don't have to step out of tower range, which is your comfort range, just to get a minion wave. So you can see right here, I'm going to quickly shove this minion wave. I see Guten top lane. I know I'm kind of safe, so I decided to take a riskier rotation. But obviously, if you don't know where Guten is, you shouldn't have not walked to the middle bush because he might just be camping there and just one-shot you right off the bat. So at this point, I'm waiting for them to get closer to me, and it's mostly going to be the enemy carries. In this case, Bruno. Look at the damage I do. One skill, one, that's 60% of the Bruno health. Right, but right after that, the reason why I'm not doing consistent damage is because I'm kind of worried about this Guten. But after I kind of figured out where Guten was actually targeting, I just had to jump in and start doing a lot of damage, right? You can see I got Bruno to 1 HP, and Guten was almost dead. I mean, got Lunox dead as well. But unfortunately, I misplayed right here. The skill 2 did not drag me through the wall. I don't know what happened. I think it's just a tiny mistake on the finger. Told you I have fat fingers, you know? So maybe that little mistake ended up costing my life because I could have easily walked away there. So right here, beautiful, beautiful ultimate from Sylvana. And by the way, I think the Sylvana actually ended up building like quite a bit of tanky items. So whenever Sylvana engage, you will see me doing a lot of damage. But if Sylvana doesn't engage, I mean, I'm just gonna play a little bit more careful. They do have a Lunox, and you will see Lunox will kill me one more time. And after I finish Athena shield, I didn't even go Immortality. If I finish Athena shield, I'm gonna have so much magic resist where Guten, Lunox not gonna pose that much threat to me, and I'll just kill the rest of the team. So I'm gonna quickly skip a little bit more farm here. After I farm the bottom of that jungle, I quickly come back to mid lane, once again go with the team, have them be the bait and get vision. I see Lunox once again, beautiful ultimate, and look at my damage I was able to do to them, right? But if your team is fighting, guys, make sure they're always in position to do damage, right? Don't be shy. You can one-shot almost anyone at this point, and that's exactly what you saw, right? If I finish like three items, if I got my Windtalker, if I got my Berserker Fury in this battle, I can one-shot any squishies, okay? Tankier character, I might need a little bit more farm, but squishies, easy, okay? So look at, even Valorant couldn't take the damage from my passive. This is why when you play Golem Marksman, don't be afraid to play a 4v5 because it's kind of fun to win those kind of type of matches, to be honest. Knowing that you're in a huge, huge disadvantage but able to carry the game, that's actually quite an achievement. And by the way, in the early of the game, I got Demon Shoes. The reason why I do that is because I throw a lot of skills in lane. With my ultimate, with my skill 1, skill 2 to proc my passive. So like I actually need a lot of mana. But later on into this game, when I get to the point where I don't ever need mana again, when I kind of finish all my items, you will see me selling the item for tough boots, where I get a little bit more magic resist, I get quad control resistance, slow resistance, with all that kind of good stuff. So right here, I almost killed the Lunox. I know Lunox was in that bush, but I didn't think I was gonna die right away. I kind of underestimated Lunox damage. But Sylvana was able to come to clean up because Lunox used all the burst on me. And I did so much damage onto the Lunox, right? Before I died. This is why after Athena shield, I don't have to go another defense item. I just killed them right away. And then this is where I was reading like how much gold do I need to sell this boots in order to get our crane boots. Because I do truly need a lot more magic resist in order to stay alive. Alright, so after a few minutes of farming, when I come back, I saw the enemy team are all mid. I decided to come top lane and take this tower. Again, all of this is happening while Bane is being completely AFK, right? You saw our Bane hitting the base, and now when I get a top lane tier 1 tower, I sell my mana boots for the tough boots. Because I don't need mana boots anymore. At this point, I have never gotten myself in a situation where I need all those mana. So, top lane tower, already lost the defense because it's over 12 minutes. So we got a tower real quick, and I'm just gonna quickly leave. I saw the enemy team on the bottom side, so that's why I knew I have enough time to take down this tower and get away in time, right? And all I did was walking away. Because Lord is coming up, so I decided to sit around the Lord area to see what I can get. In fact, I think now I remember that I actually ended up going for Immortality, second defense item, because I do have a lot of dive, which makes sense. So over here, I see them going in, immediately jump out of Belleric's ultimate, because your safety is number one, guys, always. Safety number one, and then you do damage on top of it. So, once again, easy damage. If I knew where the enemies are, if I see the team fight happening, you can bet on Dave to constantly jump in, 5-point passive, do a lot of damage. As a marksman, you want to be doing a lot of tower damage, doing a lot of hero damage every game, okay? Especially go lane, where you're going to get the most amount of resources. If your team supports you a little bit, even if your team doesn't support you, if you use my technique, just farm carefully, get a little bit more vision, predict based on the vision that you have, and then try to make the best judgment and just don't die, you're going to have a very successful time farming. So once again, beautiful ult from Sylvana, locked in, this very unfortunate prey right there, and we're able to get an easy kill. Right? There's no point in using Immortality, because I would just walk up. The thing about the Winter Truncheon is, you can only use it if your teammate is right next to you. If your teammate is right next to you, using Winter Truncheon is just pointless, right? Like, cause you're not gonna save yourself. So look at the damage I'm doing right here. Now, I'll try to hit the Bruno, but unfortunately, it's just not gonna happen, because Bruno stopped walking up, but this Sandman, Khalid, is just an unfortunate example of why you should not keep on chasing a Quinn, who has a lot of mana. Right, because if I have an infinite amount of mana and I'm super far ahead, if you keep on chasing me, I'm just gonna go ahead and proc my skill to root you down and beat you up, right, with my passive and stuff. Look at the damage I'm doing. Two auto attacks plus like one skill. That's like 80% of the health, right? Quickly use our skill to root this Valoric so he didn't walk up anymore. And then dash myself out, dodge the ultimate. Beautiful, beautiful so far. I took an enemy blue buff. At this point, I have Athena shield, I have Immortality, I'm not worried. That's why I'm chasing this guy. And it boosts a flicker out of this Lunox, which is really, really important. Gushen wanted to get me, but you will realize that my skill 2 rooted him, which he didn't realize, and sure enough, he just get one-shotted. And this is something that after you have Klin level 2, you can always do, right? Once the enemy Gushen is coming in, if you just root him, like, and it provides you an escape, also provides a root, because they're going to dash onto you. So it's actually a really, really easy counter. So over here, we killed Khalid, because we do way too much damage. Immortality ended up, you know, doing well to my favor. So after Sylvana landed another beautiful ultimate, I'm going to try to clean up everyone and just secure the enemy defense zone to our favor. Once you push enemy high ground tower, recall if you don't have enough time to push to end, right? In this case, we didn't. So I reset it, get everything ready, get my HP ready in place. I dodged Lunox ult, I saw the Lunox on the right side, and sure enough, when Lunox showed up, I was about to one-shot the Lunox, but she flickered away. The Bruno wasn't so lucky, because he didn't know how much damage I was going to do, right? The men are usually reckless, let me tell you. You know, we're a reckless animal. So the Bruno just jumped in and just killed the Bruno like no tomorrow. He didn't even know what happened. He didn't even see it and he just died. So right afterwards, enemy three people down, including Gushen down. I called my team to come do Lord. I think I was the only person doing it for quite a long time. Like, until I got this thing to like 20% HP. That's when Harith was like, oh, something's going on. I should go help. Which dropped me to like one HP, by the way. It's really risky, but risk is what you play the game for, right? So let's quickly skip forward. There was a team fight broke, apparently, right after lore spawn. You know, kudos to my team for being noobs and end up all dying. You just have to wait for the Lord. I was waiting for my Lord, get my stuff ready, get my red buff. So I just easily get a win right here, guys. If you enjoyed the gameplay, make sure to drop the like, subscribe, and turn the bell on to all notification bells. With that, Ascendant Dave signing off. See you guys next time. Just for the thrill of it, nothing counterfeit with